Okay, so now we are going to try to solve problem of distance. Okay, so this is motion along a straight line. Okay, so first of all, you have to draw the powerful diagram. Okay, SVA. Differentiate, integrate plus C. Okay, question one. Okay, so now given S equals to AT minus T squared. Okay, so now you are going to find distance. Okay, just now I told you that you have two things you have to remember. Okay, the first one, test V equal to zero, change direction. And the second one, choose distance formula. Okay, now we have to test V equal to zero. This is the first step there. Okay, we have S. Okay, we have S. Okay, but we must use V. So from S to get V, you have to differentiate. So V equals to dS dt. So V equals to 8 minus 2t equal to 0. Equal to 0. So 8 equals to 2t, t equals to 4. Okay, so t equals to 4 means masa t equals to 4, the particle change direction. Change direction. Okay, so back to the question. Okay, dia nak total distance traveled by the particle in the first 3 seconds. Okay, tengok tadi, total distance traveled in the first 3 seconds. So tengok ni, formula tadi ada 2 kan. Okay, so nak pilih yang mana? Yang first, total distance traveled in the first n second. Yang the second one, distance at the n second. So, mestilah kita guna formula nombor 1 kan? Okay, so nak cari dia, maksudnya daripada t kosong sampai, kalau n second ni, for example 4, t kosong sampai t 4 lah. Tapi sekarang kita, in the first 3 second eh. So maksudnya kita nak cari daripada t sama dengan 0 sampai t sama dengan 3. Okay, tetapi particle ni change direction dekat t sama dengan 4 selepas ni. Dia change direction dekat sini. So dia tak kacau dia punya movement. Maksud sebab t 4 ni berlaku change direction ni selepas t sama dengan 3. So masa ni kita terus je lah cari total distance travel. So total distance travel in the first 3 second ni, terus je kita yang final, dia punya final eh. So masukkan T equals to 3 into S, tolak, masukkan T equals to 0 into S. Okay, ni S kita tadi saya dah petakkan. Okay, so now kita masukkan T equals to 3. So we get here 8 times 3 minus 3 squared minus T equal to 0, 8 times 0 minus 0 squared. Okay, 8 times 3 24 minus 9. Berapa 24 minus 9? 15 meter. Okay, clear eh? Okay, so The second one ni, the total distance the total distance in the first 7 second. So distance 7 second eh. Okay, so 7 second, tengok formula mana total distance in the first 7 second. Okay, ni same, guna formula yang pertama. Okay, daripada T0 sampai T4. Okay, so from T0 to T7, in this situation, ikut soalan ni sampai T7 lah kan. Okay, ikut soalan ni daripada T0 sampai T7 lah. Tapi perasan tak tadi, kita dapati dia change direction dekat T sama dengan 4. So T sama dengan 4 kat sini, dia kacau dia punya movement of the particle. So in this situation, you have to find one by one. Okay, you have to find you have to find T0 into S, then you have to find T4 into S, then you have to substitute t equals to 7 into s. Okay. So bila t 0, masukkanlah dalam s tadi, eh. So 8 times 0 minus 0 squared sama dengan 0. Okay, t 4, 8 times 4 minus 4 squared. Okay, 32 minus 16. So 16. Okay, t equal to 7. 8 times 7 minus 7 squared. So which is 7. Okay, so nampak tak kat sini? So then we draw the movement of the particle, eh? 0, 16, 7. Okay, here is 0. Okay, 16 positive, so to the right. Okay, so jadi dia punya dekat sini change direction, eh? Okay, sebab tadi kan T4 kan? Okay, so T4 ni dia change direction. Okay, so sekarang ni masa ni dia dia corner, dia reverse direction. Okay, so dia start kat sini lah, T0. Then masa dekat sini dia corner. Okay, T equals to 4. Okay, lepas tu 7. Okay, 7 still positive but less than 16, more than 0. So 7 somewhere here lah, 7. So dekat sini when T equals to 7. Okay. So nampak tak dia punya movement? Tadi kan kita dah buat banyak contoh ni kan. So kita boleh carilah total distance. So after this saya, kalau total distance travel tu, saya tulis TDT je. Total distance travel. Okay, yang ni this way ni, macam nak cari 16 minus 0. So 16 lah kan. So ni 16 minus 0, eh. So 16 lah. Okay, tambah yang ni. Okay, 7 tolak 16. Tapi dia dia move to the line, nanti dapat negatif. Tapi distance always positive, kita make it modulus lah. 7 tolak 16. Okay, so ni akan dapat positive, eh. 16 plus 9 equals to 25. Okay, meter. So macam itu. So nampak tak? So tadi important kita tahu semula, eh, important kita tahu yang dia punya change direction ni. Okay, T sama dengan 4. Dia change direction dekat T sama 4. Okay, untuk soalan pertama, dia nak daripada T kosong sampai T 3, yang dia change direction T 4. So dia tak effect lah kan. Okay, tapi contoh yang kedua, dia nak daripada T kosong sampai T 7, dia change direction dekat T 4. So dia kacau. Masa dia change direction tu, dia kacau movement of the particle lah. Bila dia kacau, kita kena buat panjang sikit lah. Kita kena cari one by one. You have to substitute T0 dalam S, T4 dalam S, T7 dalam S. Lepas tu kita kena draw the position of the particle ni on the number line. Lepas tu kita dapatkan dia punya TDT. Boleh? Okay, so now we go to the second question. Okay, still in motion along a straight line. So the powerful diagram as VA. Differentiate, integrate plus C, integrate plus C. Okay, question number two. Okay, here the displacement as meter of a particle moving along a straight line and passes through a fixed point O is given by S. Equals to 40 minus T squared. Okay, I put in the box. Okay, where T is a time in second after passing through O. Okay, determine total distance. Okay, so distance, two things you have to remember. The first one just now, tadi sama. Okay, like example number one. Test V equals to 0. Choose distance formula. Okay, test V equals to 0. To choose distance formula. Okay, so test V equals to 0, eh. So, same thing. We have S. We want to use V So from S to get V, so you have to differentiate. So V equals to ds dt. So V equals to 4 minus ni 2t. Okay, equal to 0. Equal to 0. So 4 equals to 2t, so t equals to 2. Okay, so t equals to 2, dia change direction. Change direction. Okay, question A. Determine the total distance in the first 2 seconds. Total distance in the first 2 seconds. Okay, choose formula. Formula tadi. Total distance travel in the first ni. Dengan distance at the end second. So, which one? Of course, the first one. So, total distance travel. So, start from 0 lah. So, kita nak cari from t equal to 0 to in the first 2 second t equals to 2. Okay. So, now change direction betul-betul dekat t sama dengan 2. So now the apa nama dia tak kacau lah movement of the particle So terus je lah masukkan substitute total distance travel t dt. Terus dia substitute t to into s minus substitute t equal to 0 into s. But dia tak kacau the movement of the particle. Okay, so substitute t equal to into s. Okay, s in the box. Okay, so we have here 4 times 2 minus 2 squared minus substitute t0 into s. 4 times 0 minus 0 squared. Okay, 4 times 2, 8, 8 minus 4 is 4 meter. Very easy. Because it's not effect, does not affect the movement of the particle. Okay, B. Total distance travel by the particle in the first 4 second. Total distance travel in the first. Okay, choose formula. Okay, total distance travel. Formula number 1. Okay, so means we have to find total distance from t equals to 0 to t equals to 4. Sebab in the first 4 second. Okay, so T0 to 2T4. Okay, just now we have tested. Okay, dia change direction when T equals to 2. Kita nak 0 sampai 4 tapi dia change direction dekat T equals to 2. So, dia effect tak dia punya movement of the particle? Kat dalam ni kan? Between ni kan? So, T equals to 2. Dia kacau. So, this one, bila dia kacau, kita kena find one by one. Okay, so you have to substitute T equals to 0 into S. Okay, 4 times 0 minus 0 squared. Okay, equals to 0. Okay, substitute t equals to 2 into s. So, t equals to 2. S equals to 4 times 2 minus 2 squared. So, berapa ni? 4 lah kan? Okay, so then substitute t equals to 4 into s. So, 4 times 4 minus 4 squared. So, equals to 0. Okay. So, don't forget dia change direction dekat sini Change direction tadi dekat t equals to 2 So, dekat sini dia reverse. Okay. So, now you draw this situation on the Cartesian plane. Sorry, on the number line. Okay, 0 fixed point. Okay, so ni. All these things you have to put into the number line. Okay, so 4 positive. So to the right. So ni 4. Okay, tengok. So start here. When t 0, s 0. So start here, t equal to 0. Okay, t 2, s 4. Masa ni reverse. Masa ni ada corner. Okay, so ni t equals to 2. The direction from left to the right. Okay. So then T4 S 0 balik. Passes through O again. So ni. So ni T equals to 4. Nampak? Macam mana? How to find the total distance of this particle. Okay. So T DT. Cari je lah. From here to here 4 meter. Campur yang ni 4 meter juga. So 4 plus 4 equals to 8 meter. So total distance travel 8 meter. So clear eh? The second one tu dah nampak sikit kan? Okay, ni kena test V0, kena choose distance formula. Okay, so kita dah test V0. When V0, T equals to 2. Means when T equals to 2, the particle change the direction. The particle reverse, the particle stop, the particle rest. Okay, so soalan nombor 1, dia nak total distance in the first 2 second. Kita kena cari from T0 to T2. Tapi dia change direction dekat T2, so tak effect. Sebab dia on the dot, memang betul-betul waktu tu. Jadi dia tak kacau pun. So kalau tak kacau, so terus je, direct. Okay, substitute equals to 2 into S dan substitute equals to 0 into S. So dapat. Tapi for the second one, total distance travel by the particle in the first 4 second. Maksud daripada T0 sampai T4. T0 to T4. Tapi dia change direction dekat T equals to 2. So, effect the movement of the particle. Bila effect the movement of the particle, kita kena find one by one. Okay? So, means substitute T0 into S, substitute T2 into S and substitute T4 into S. Kita dapat lah. Bila dah dapat semua ni, so we have to represent the position of the particle ni on the number line. So bila kita lukis baru clear, baru kita dapat nampak macam mana movement of the particle. So then kita boleh find out lah the total distance travel by the particle.